all of us really need to focus on new technology for delivery of knowledge. I think web and internet has changed everything. It has changed business models. It has changed delivery systems. And you have instant access to information. So you don't need to learn the way I learned 50 years ago. The learning models have changed. So in a sense, I really don't need teacher. But when you say that, people react because it's too radical. I need mentor. Because teacher today comes to class and delivers same lecture over and over again. I don't need teacher to create a lecture, nor do I need teacher to deliver a lecture. But I need teacher as a mentor. Because material is already on the web. I can take it whenever I want. So take, for example, in medical, people have to learn all the words of every body part today. I can get it on Google. I can have it on my mobile phone. So the whole idea of taking 4 years to get a degree, I want to question that today. Why do I need 2 years to get a master's? What does it mean to get a degree? Why do I spend $50,000 or $100,000 to get an MBA? So I think we will have to really begin to think very differently. What does it mean to deliver health service? Do I really need to go to doctor's office and wait for an hour to get an appointment? Can I get my simple information on mobile phone? I can have my doctor probably 10,000 miles away from me. I need some things locally, and I can do a lot of things from remote location. So I believe everything we do today is obsolete. Everything. How do we get a driver's license? How do we get birth certificate? We need new ways of doing things because we have new technology. See, to me, the world can be divided between pre-internet, post-internet. Internet is the biggest invention after language. Language was the first thing 15,000 years ago that brought people together. But it created communities. Internet is something that brought world together. What is important for education today is one new learning model and educate people to think on their own and encourage people to learn as they go along. So you really don't need anything except three things today for education. One is motivation. I have to be motivated that I want to learn. Two, I need time. And three, I need content. That's it. I don't need teacher, don't need classroom, don't need certificate, don't need any of that. So everything we value today is obsolete. If I'm motivated, if I have time, I can learn how to make wine on internet. I couldn't do that before. So I think we are underestimating the power of the tool we have.
Las relaciones entre Chile e India va a aumentar en una manera muy significativa, porque cuando Chile puede proyectar sí mismo como una plataforma no solo para Chile, pero para toda la América Latina, eso será el día cuando va a lanzar las relaciones en una manera muy, muy impresionante. Entonces estamos mencionando esto a todos los indios, todos los grupos, las delegaciones, las empresas. Y ya han comenzado aquí en Chile sus operaciones. Empresas muy grandes de la India, como Godrej, como Ashok Leyland, como Mahindra, como Oracle Financial Services, Tega Industries, Wipro Tecnología Informática y muchos más. Porque para ellos, Chile tiene un sistema que es muy transparente. No hay corrupción, hay mucha seguridad y pueden basar sus operaciones en Chile para hacer el trabajo en este continente. Entonces, esto a mí me parece es una cosa muy significativa. We have just a very simple example. If we start today by having an India-Chile Scientist Forum, suppose both sides decide to put very small amount of money, $1 million from India, $1 million from Chile, and we bring together the scientists, automatically you'll have ideas, you'll have projects, you'll have thoughts, you'll have imagination, you'll have dreams, and that will create immediately a great base for what you are mentioning.
Una cosa notable es la experiencia de la India, que logró transformar su economía de producir una cierta cantidad de bienes, muchos de ellos agrícolas, a lo que tiene hoy, que es producir tecnología y servicios de información. Esa transición requirió capital humano avanzado, para lo cual lograron modificar su sistema educativo creando universidades de excelencia, como son los institutos tecnológicos de la India. También logró crear justamente un ambiente, un ecosistema para atraer inversionistas extranjeros, como me correspondió ver a mí el caso de Microsoft, que instaló uno de sus laboratorios de investigación en la ciudad de Bangalore. Y en tercer lugar, el poder justamente empezar a mover una sociedad que es muy heterogénea, mucho más heterogénea que la chilena, en un propósito común. Te fijas, de ser un actor competitivo en el mercado global. Yo creo que esas características, algunas de ellas son replicables en Chile, otras no, somos distintos en otros aspectos, pero la experiencia de poder ir moviéndonos paulatinamente de una economía basada en recursos naturales a una economía basada en el conocimiento, que es justamente la meta que tenemos para convertir a Chile en un país desarrollado, obtiene un buen soporte a partir de la experiencia de la India.